Hello, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a summer 2014 LEGO Legends of Chima set. This is Cragger's Fire Striker. It comes with 380 pieces. So they call this the Fire Striker, but I feel like it has less fire elements in it and less fire style to its design than some of the other vehicles. It kind of adds on the fire stuff almost as just afterthoughts. You know, they've got the little bits of fire showing up in here. Fire chi crystals, that's good. And some fire just coming out the sides randomly, small little bits up here. I'm actually happy that they stayed with the original crocodile scheme of the colors with the olive green and a lot of dark green. You'll see a few parts in here that are also new for dark green for this year, I believe. But you know, it's good to see them sticking to their guns with the color scheme and not trying to make crocodile stuff all completely red. There's plenty of red back here. I'm not too happy with or fond of the exposed Technic lift arms. Not at all. Especially with the blue axle pins that stick. They really stick out to me. I really could have done without the blue ones. I wish they could bring back the black ones. Would look a lot better. But to me, all of this shaping back here is just kind of a throwaway as far as the look of the thing. You've got nice details with the wheels. I think the claws here, the teeth around the edges are nice. You can see they're trying to create eyes right in there using what were originally designed to be eye elements for Bionicle and actually using those as eyes once again. The thing rolls really easily because it's on very large wheels and they're hard plastic, they're not rubber, so they're not gonna pick up a whole lot of lint, they're not gonna get stuck in carpets and stuff like that, so I think that's good. You got your shooters on the sides, two of them, very easy to access from behind, very easy to just get your fingers on there and just shoot, that's a good thing, but they do angle down a little bit because the whole thing is kind of angled down and forward. So if you really want this to shoot more up, you gotta bring the thing up and give it, you know, do a little bit of a wheelie with the whole thing. However, there is another alternative, and this will show you the reason for all of the Technic stuff that's exposed. You can enter Fire Chi power mode by pushing down on the tail. Now, it might start to create a little bit of a wheelie, so you kind of have to hold down the front wheels most of the time, but this is a pretty nice little change, actually. Let's take a look at it from the front so you can see it even better. See, it opens up the mouth and everything, and now the angles of these what were side pods that are now up in the air, that looks pretty cool. Very aggressive and really looks like it's coming after you now. You know, the opening mouth is a cool thing. You see a third fire chi crystal inside of there. So this thing definitely has to have a lot of power. And I just know that younger kids are gonna love transforming this thing back and forth between the two modes because it opens up, it closes, it opens, it closes. You've got the jaw that's opening and closing. It almost looks like it's flapping. It has that clicking sound. It's just all good for play value for younger kids. I know older kids are probably not gonna be very impressed by that. They'll just choose their favorite mode. It's good for storage to be able to put that away, but just a cool little play action there. And if you're wondering, that is where Cragger would sit up on top of the thing. So he looks really small relative to the whole vehicle. So I guess that explains why it needs so much power. Three minifigs in this set. It's Cragger, the croc obviously, Vornon, the vulture, and Stealthor, the saber-tooth. I think the weapons are pretty reasonably sized compared to the norms for Chima. Cragger gets a fire claw. Vornon gets what's called an ice slice. And then there's a clawsicle for Stealthor. All pretty good looking weapons, I would say. My favorite of these definitely is the fire claw for Cragger. I think it's got some good posability to it also because you can change the angles of the kind of teeth there. And it really looks like you can do some active attacks with the thing. It's also chi powered, which you can also see over here with the clawsicle, but this one's got the nice little fire chi emblem on it. Here's a look at the figures from the back. But as usual, there's not a whole lot to see there other than the wings, so let's take some stuff off. And there now you can see the prints on the torsos as well as the alternate faces for two of them. The vultures do not get alternate faces, they just get their main one. This is what you get for the bad guys with this set. It's a very beautiful little terrain piece. They call it ice flowers. Really nice to get those foliage pieces in a trans light blue. Just makes me want to get a couple hundred of those things and make a huge, beautiful, glowing tree. But the reason this is related to the bad guys is not just the whole frost and ice thing, but you've also got a little catapult there, and you've got these little frost canisters or just, you know, ice rocks or something that you can put in there and shoot those off at the fire striker. So there you go. That's my look at this set. I personally am not really a fan of this one, but like I said, I am positive that the youngest fans of LEGO Legends of Chima toys will love the action of this thing going back and forth between its standard and Fire Chi power modes. Really good stuff. Pretty respectable figures, you know, fully adorned with all of their stuff. And a handful of cool new colors for pieces. Please share your thoughts in a comment if you like the set, if you don't like the set, if there are any specific things about it that you want to talk about. Always good to see. Time for me to go build some more stuff so I can bring you some more videos. Thanks so much for watching this one. I'll be talking to you again very soon.